Hi, I'm Dr. Stephen Bartol, and I'm the Chief Medical Officer at Henry Ford Innovations. I want to share with you some of the projects that we're working on here at the Henry Ford Innovation Institute. Projects that came from people just like you, people who work here at Henry Ford.
The Innovation Institute was presented with a problem that we didn't even know existed. An OR nurse named Debbie says that they open these Genesis cases as many as 300 to 500 times a day. There's a little plastic piece that goes in these cases that they have to break. And it may not sound difficult, but if you're doing it all day, every day, we were finding that your fingers were starting to hurt and these nurses were getting carpal tunnel.
They're finding out that your thumbs and the side of your index fingers kind of a little pain and some, you know, as we get older, our joints aren't as good as they used to be. So I thought I'd create something that would open up, make our life a little easier. And we do have a lot of trays in ortho, so we're always popping. And instead of using two hands, a nice little device.
So we prototyped tools to find a shape that worked and contracted a local manufacturer to build them for us. And we're now ready to give them away as gifts from Debbie and Nancy Schlichting to the OR nurses around the system.
I love that project because it started with an idea that came from someone who works with me here on the operating room at Henry Ford Hospital main campus. All innovation starts with a problem. The interventional cardiology group at Henry Ford Hospital had a very challenging problem. Working together at the Henry Ford Innovation Institute, we were able to help them develop a very unique solution to that problem.
I think what many people miss about 3D printing, though, is the interplay between creativity and complexity, where a physician, a surgeon, a cardiologist can have this idea and try to visualize it in a three-dimensional space where we normally work in two dimensions, an x-ray, a picture, things like this, and it allows us to plan more carefully surgical procedures.
The model really allows us to take a look in a three-dimensional way at how the valves would fit inside the heart and whether they would bump up against other structures.
30% of the population actually has moderate to severe leakage around that valve. That will actually cause heart failure symptoms, difficulty breathing, shortness of breath. And eventually, at 2 years, these patients have been found in statistical studies to do worse and have higher rates of hospitalization for heart failure readmissions, something that could be prevented if we could actually have 3D printing technology in the future to better assess the outcome and fit of these valves.
So there's really some risk, and there hasn't been enough accuracy in figuring out exactly what size of valve, and even more importantly, in the future, there's going to be at least 4 types of valves available in the U.S. So what size, what type, and then that's where the 3D modeling really comes in, because we'll honestly be able to take each individual valve in a patient's heart model and put a valve in and see exactly how it fits.
They can actually assess what the anatomy was of the patient and the interactions with multiple structures. So with this anatomy right here, this patient has an existing surgical valve. You might be able to see this on a CT scan, but you won't be able to feel it and you won't be able to size it. We can simulate putting valves in here to see how it interacts with other parts of the body.
2 weeks ago, there was a patient that was referred to us that we thought we were going to be able to fix her mitral valve. But when we did the model, we recognized that if we put a new valve inside her old valve, it would occlude the outflow to the heart and the patient would die. For sure, we prevented a death by using this model. And we've come to really rely on a lot to make management decisions about sizing of valves, types of valves, and whether or not even new valves could fit into the old valves with these 3D models.
Much of the work that went into that cardiac valve project was done here at the Innovation Institute by our designers. We have a team of designers that are able to use design software, 3D printing, and other tools to help you take your idea and transform it from a napkin drawing to a real project. Here's a great example of a project that happened just that way.
One of Henry Ford Hospital's respiratory therapists, John Bono,
came up with an idea to treat patients who are having trouble expelling mucus from their lungs. The current market solutions only serve patients who aren't on a ventilator. John's idea was to modify the Quake device to work with ventilated patients. We realized that there was an opportunity to design a device from scratch that was specifically made to interface with a ventilator. So using HFII's 3D printing capacity, we've made many prototypes, one of which we're happy with and have decided to patent. And that patent will allow us to shop industry interest and hopefully move forward with production. My name is Eric Myers. I'm a product designer for the Innovation Institute.
It's not all about gadgets. Sometimes the ideas come from the digital realm. We're really focused on this digital space right now, looking at software and apps that have healthcare applications. Here's an idea that came from two members of our house staff who had an idea for an app to help them better manage patients while on call.
StatChat was created with the goal of patient safety in mind. The concept was created after a night on a difficult trauma call. We had a lot of sick patients. They needed a lot of consultants and consulting services on board. The idea was to have a patient-centered communication tool where we can all keep connected, especially the healthcare providers who had a vested interest in the patient. And that way, we're able to get information real time, so we're able to treat the patient accordingly without delay. I decided to undergo an innovation fellowship at the Henry Ford Innovation Institute, and Peter Adams was also a co-fellow with me. He had a great input and certain things we should change and certain things we can do and if it was feasible and whatnot. So we just kind of took the idea and we just ran with it. And if you look at literature, adverse patient outcomes are related to lack in communication. And not a lot of people know this, and a lot of people take it for granted. There was just a recurrent theme that kept coming up. It was communication. So we thought we need to solve this problem, and I think StatChat can do that. We partnered up with Vision IT, a local app company here in Detroit. They've created a prototype and we should be piloting that within the next month. It's very, very exciting. I know a lot of people say, use the cliche, disruptive technology, or this is the next big thing or a game changer. But I definitely believe that StatChat is the future of communication in healthcare. And I'm really excited to be at the forefront of that, definitely.
Have you had the opportunity to feel uncomfortable in a hospital gown? Well, there's good news, because one of our designers at the Henry Ford Innovation Institute helped develop the new Model G patient hospital gown.
The number one issue with the patient hospital gown in any hospital that you go to is that patient's backside is revealed whenever they're walking around or rolling over in bed. So there's a sense of embarrassment and lack of dignity when you're trying to recover in the hospital. So while we're trying to appease the patients and the clinicians at the same time, we granted them access in the back where we've closed it for the patients, but we've created an access panel for any physician, whatever their need might be.
After the transplant, one of the first things they want you to do is get up and walk. You want me to do what? Well, the last thing I want to be worrying about, as I've got that IV pole in one hand and my wife in the other arm, is going down the hall worrying if my rear end is exposed. You know, I'm much less resistant to getting out in the hallway and walking if I've got that closed up in the front.
So if we came up with a fun name for the hospital gown, and you know, it really talks to our heritage as a health system, Henry Ford, and what he did with the Model T and rolling that out on the assembly line and really changing the world of automotive. We've decided to call our patient gown the Model G. Carhartt makes quality products, and we wanted a quality gown for our patients. We spent the time to create the design, but we wanted to make sure that it was fabricated really well, because hospital gowns go through a tremendous amount of wear and tear in the laundry process. Over the course of several months, we were able to come to an agreement, and they'll be supplying Henry Ford Health System with 35,000 gowns. So if you look at the gown, it actually has no room for patients to be revealed or their privacy to be compromised. But then as you come up here, you have this access panel that actually opens up, and clinicians can have any type of access that they need, and then it just falls right on top of itself. So you can see we have a series of 8 snaps on the front and in 2 columns, and then you open up the gown and you have clinician access. And for smaller patients, you can move down to the smaller size so that they can have a more custom fit.
It's almost like a paperclip. At the end of the day, you look at that and you go, it's brilliant. It takes something very simple, and yet you now have elegance with that. So it is more comfortable, it is more dignified, and paradoxically, it's easier for us to use as healthcare providers.
I was here for many days and many nights, and that new hospital gown was maybe a little thing, but it had a big effect on making me feel that I was wearing something that I might even wear at home.
Some ideas may seem a little far-fetched when we first look at them, but you never know where the future of medicine is going to take us, so we don't dismiss these ideas outright. In fact, sometimes they turn into more than we expected. Here's an idea that came to us from Henry Ford Home Health.
For the nurse who arrives at the patient's home and needs to do some type of infusion care or needs to do some type of wound care and the appropriate supplies aren't there. She calls into the office dispatches it by drone, and the nurse has the supplies that she or he needs to provide care in the home. For stat labs, when specimens are drawn in the home and we have to get the results back quickly. Why not have the drone pick it up, take it to the lab, drop it off at the lab, the nurse goes on to her next visit, does whatever she needs to do, and gets the call back if it's a critical lab value. We have about 600 employees that make over 300,000 home visits a year and clock over 4 million miles a year. The time that nurses spend transporting labs is not only aggravating for the nurse, but it's also a non-productive time that keeps us away from patient care, and it's something that we don't get paid to do. I would love to see this become a reality, just from the realm of possibilities, what this could do in terms of not only improving the lives of patients, you know, one person at a time, but expanding and extending the Henry Ford brand out in the community, out into the patients' homes, is a very cool thing. I would love to see it happen.
The best new ideas come from people who work directly in healthcare, people just like you. So we'd like to hear about your ideas. Come visit us here at the Henry Ford Innovation Institute, or check out our website, or if you'd like, you can contact me directly. Or if you'd like, send me a message by drone.